As another wild incident on the roads this morning, another driver led police on a chase up the Southwest Freeway toward downtown around lunchtime. We caught the chase on our Houston Transtar cameras, and Channel 2's Phil Archer was on the scene as the driver finally came to a halt just before the I-45 interchange. Phil is live now with this dramatic ending.
Yeah, that chase wasn't hard to find. It actually passed by the Channel 2 studios at Southwest Freeway and Beechnut this morning. The driver they were chasing had to swerve around our truck just as we pulled out of the parking lot. It had begun miles from there in Bel Air, where the driver was reportedly running cars off the West Loop, and it ended here near downtown after she slammed into a police car. Transtar cameras recorded the chase as the white Lincoln swerved through traffic headed north on the Southwest Freeway. By the time the car got to the West Loop at 59, the driver had already hit the concrete retaining wall once and rear-ended a police car that was trying to force her to stop. Accident investigators still aren't sure how many other cars were hit along the way.
Just coming up for the merge, and the white car came out of nowhere and just hit me from the left.
The chase didn't stop until the driver slammed into a parked HISD police car at the intersection of 59 and I-45. That officer wasn't part of the chase. She'd pulled over to help a stranded motorist. Alejandro Gonzalez and his family stopped to help too. He was the first to get to the suspect driver after she stepped out of her wrecked car.
Our hands were all the way out, and as soon as I was running towards her, there was cops with guns on my back. So I turned around and I ran back to the truck, and I saw a cop that was shook up. So I kind of pulled her to the side, ran back, and got my mom.
Police identify the suspect as 27-year-old Derica Jefferson. Jefferson has previously been convicted of misdemeanor theft and felony drug possession. She wasn't hurt in the crash, and she seemed unfazed afterwards, blowing us a kiss as she headed to jail. Police still aren't sure why it happened, what set off the chase. They have some concerns about Jefferson's mental state. She's expected to be charged with a felony, evading arrest. Reporting live downtown, I'm Phil Archer, KPRC Channel 2 News. Hi.